أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Jumaa Mubarak, inshallah. It is not a bid'ah or an innovation or anything, inshallah. Jumaa Mubarak, this is the best day of Salat al-Fajr. The Fajr of Salat al-Jumaa, Rasulullah said that in the Hadith. The best salah, it is the salah of Salat al-Fajr in the day of Jumaa, which is today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us. Ameen ya Rahman Rahimeen. We're still in our journey for the family, marriage, raising kids, relationship between husband and wife, and you have to understand too many things that inshallah it will benefit us, our life, with our inshallah journey with our family, inshallah Rabbil Alameen, or our families. When you get, you're looking for a spouse, don't worry about, you know, how much money they have, don't worry about what kind of car they have, house they have, all of this doesn't have any value when you compare it with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because like what they said, الفقر مش في قلة الفلوس ولكن الفقر في قلة الرأي. They said that poverty, it is not because you don't have money. The poverty is here. Where is the poverty? Here. Yes, if you are poor here, you have all the money of Qarun. Nothing has no value. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks about al-munafiq in the Holy Quran, said, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ تُعْجِبُكَ أَجْسَامُهُمْ وَإِنْ يَقُولُوا تَسْمَعَ لِقَوْلِهِمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ خُشُبٌ مُسَنَّدٌ يَحْسَبُونَ كُلَّ صَيْحَةٍ عَلَيْهِمْ هُمُ الْعَدُوُّ فَاحْذَرْهُمْ قَتَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَنَّى يُؤْفَكُونَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the munafiq, their bodies, they please you. They are pleasing you when you look at them. When they talk, you listen to them. But in reality, they are your enemy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. But don't worry about the whatever you see from people. مر رجل على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال ما تقولون في هذا. A man was passing by رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام. The Rasul asked his companion, what do you think about that guy? Look what they say. قالوا هذا أحرى أن إن خطب أن ينكح وإن شفع أن يشفع وإن قال أن يستمع له. That guy, if he went to any, if he goes to any house of the houses of Al-Madina to get married, they will give him. If he speaks, they will listen to him. And if he goes to intercede for somebody, people will accept his intercession. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was quiet little while. Another man was passing by. But another man was poor, faqir. You know, he looked at his clothes, the way he's walking and the way he's talking. His poor faqir, and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the same question. What do you think about that guy? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking. They said, this guy, if he goes to any house of houses of Al-Madinah, nobody gonna give him his daughter. And if he intercede, nobody gonna accept his intercession. If he speaks, nobody gonna listen to him. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had, قال, هذا خير من ملء الأرض من هذا. The hadith in Sahih Bukhari. The second man, better than full of the earth of that first man. Don't worry about this. Don't worry about whatever they have. Don't worry about the car. Don't worry about the house. Don't worry about all of this. And this is exactly the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why he said, if somebody comes to you asking for marriage, your sister, your daughter, somebody in your family, subhanAllah, look to his deen first. إِذَا جَاءَكُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَوْنَ دِينَهُ first. And his manner. وَخُلُقَهُ فَزَوْجُوهُ. And to be honest with you, manners are very important for me from the deen itself. If somebody has deen, praying and coming to the masjid, and he has no manners, what the deen, what the bride gonna benefit him? Yes, it's salah. We are practicing the salah to show that in our bodies, in our manners, in our akhlaq. You know, we are not doing like a biku fakraw, just we're coming, Allahu Akbar, Salamu Alaikum, do whatever you want. It's not like that. No, Islam is telling you, put yourself in this track and go. You cannot just do whatever you want. We're being controlled by Islam. Otherwise, anybody can do whatever he want. There is a law in this country, right? If there is no law, there is no law to control people, to punish those who are making crimes, anybody can get a knife or a gun, you can make me mad, poof, in your head, and they finish you. That's it. I have muscles. But we have law, we have system, Islam too, the same. It is not, مش عايشين هنا في الغابة. Very important thing about this. فالناس اللي بتهتم بالمظاهر وتترك الجوهر, this is not, it's not good at all. You have to look to the, what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying. طيب, now I'm going to marry that girl or that lady. Now, alhamdulillah, I make salat istikhara. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rab, help me for this choice. And Allah guided me. And I finally, I'm about to think about her. طيب, what Islam allowed you to look at her in the beginning, just before the marriage? Just going in the engagement time. I want to look at her. Is that permissible for you to look at her body? And what part of her body you can look? This is big problem now in the social media, because some sheikhs, al-Zahiriyin, Madrasat Ibn Hazm, they go behind the bar, behind the limits, and they said you can look at her, all of her body, but don't let her know. I'm not accepting this. Because sometimes when you explain the deen, the sharia, according to the Arabic language, doesn't make sense sometimes. Like, for, because there's some sawabit, you have to take it as is. Don't use the Arabic language with the grammar, whatever in it. And this is some of the, يعني صراحة, the mistakes of Sheikh, like Sheikh Sha'rawi in the Creed. Sheikh Sha'rawi is a big scholar of tafsir. I'm making his tafsir every Friday. But I'm mixing it with Nur al-Bayan, my tafsir, and I get the right thing with the Creed, I bought it. I'm not claiming I'm better than him, or I'm a scholar. No, I'm not claiming anything. But the point here is, Sharia, you cannot put all the Sharia and you judge the Sharia because of the Arabic language. Like Taha Hussein. Taha Hussein was the Egyptian scholar too. He came to the point because he was Amid al-Adab al-Arabi. He came to the point, he said, there is some mistakes in the grammar in the Quran. Because his knowledge, he came to the very high, and this is kufr. But the man before his death, he repented and he said, I was mistaken. See? Sometimes when you come to the point and you think you have everything, you know everything, you want to say the Quran is wrong and the grammar. He come to this point, Mustafa Hussein, yes. And he tried to say, subhanAllah, we have to know, not everything you have to judge the Quran or you have to judge the Sharia according to this, your brain, because your brain is not perfect. You're not perfect. And some ibadat, something you have to take it as is. Okay. طيب هنا some scholars they said no, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said انظر إليها, look at her, إليها كلها يعني مهما فسرها كده باللغة العربية, look at her, all of her, yes they said yes, even if she's taking shower go by and don't let her know and look at all of her body, why? Maybe she has some kind of sickness in her skin or something like that. البضاعة مضروبة, هتاخد واحدة مضروبة. لازم you have to take somebody perfect. Of course, I disagree completely about that. Let's see what the hadith said. قال أبو هريرة كنت مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأتاه رجل. أبو هريرة said I was with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and a man came to him. فأخبره أنه تزوج امرأة من الأنصار. That man, he told رسول الله, يا رسول الله, I get married from a lady from الأنصار, a woman from الأنصار. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, أنظرت إليها, did you look at her? This is the problem in Arabic here. إليها, إلها عايدة عليها هي. إليها كلها, all of her. Did you look at her? At her where يعني? Her neck, ولا her hand, ولا her face, ولا her all of her body? All of her body. It doesn't work, all of her body. Cannot work like that. انظر إليها, I'm gonna tell you what the scholar said. قال لا. And the man told رسول الله, no, I did not look at her. Like the old fashion when people used to marry, he just only saw her during her night of the wedding night. He never saw her before. That doesn't work there. Doesn't work too, especially nowadays. You know? فصلى الله عليه وسلم said, انظر إليها أحرى أن يؤدم بينكما. I love رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام. Look what he said. Look at her. Maybe that will bring love between you and her. Yeah, she can attract you somehow, you can attract her somehow. Very important. And this is our youth nowadays. Don't let your daughter or your son just go marry like this, to be honest with you. From my experience, no, don't do this. Give her a chance, give her a time, especially if you have a daughter. Give her time and let her choose her husband. don't choose for her. I know you have to pick her up with some advices, but in the end, if the guy is okay, 70%, I'm not saying 100%, nobody 100%. 70% is, if he is okay, especially with the deen, say Bismillah if she likes him. Because she likes him, she's the one she's gonna marry him and she's gonna live with him. Otherwise, no, don't worry about money, don't worry about family, don't worry about all of this. If that comes plus the deen, it's okay, like what I explained before. But if you have no deen and you have all of these, whatever, no, don't worry about it. فهنا قال وقال إذا خطب أحدكم المرأة فإن استطاع أن ينظر إلى ما يدعوه في نكاحها فليفعل وإن كانت لا تعلم. That hadith also said, if you engage a lady, or if you want to marry from a lady, if you can, إن استطعت, if you are capable, if you will be able to look at her or look at what can attract you from her to get married from her, do that. What the scholar said, how can you look at her? They said, the face and the hand. And you can look at the leg too. I will give you some proofs. Yeah. Yes, you can look at her legs, you can look at her face, you can look at her hand. This is the maximum. And nowadays, alhamdulillah, well, I have my sister, I have my mom. I can send her to check. Sometimes she pull her from her head to see she has hair or not. Do you know that it's happened? It's happened in Egypt before 1980s. I remember that man, that lady, she was wearing a wig. She was bald. And she, subhanAllah, she been after her marriage for a couple of months, she's wearing the scarf all the time. And her husband said, I want to see your hair. What is this? SubhanAllah, somehow they've been fighting and he was pulling hair from her head and she, that's a wig. What is this? The lady, she's a bald lady. He went to the judge and he divorced her from him. He divorced him. He has a right to do it. She cheated him. Yes, of course, this is, she lied. What is this? I marry a lady with hair. What is your hair? You know? Yes, yes. And the judge, he divorced her. That's why, very important. إذا كان الإنسان جاد في الخطبة والزواج فليفعل ذلك. أما إذا كان هناك اختلاط محرم طبعا باسم المدنية الزائفة. يعني if صراحة الإسلام also is protecting us men and women. By the name of this new civilization, people they are mixing now. Women naked and they sit with men and this is haram. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, authentic hadith, there is a fitna will happen to my ummah, like Bani Israel, children of Jacob before. Money and women. And the worst fitna for my ummah, it is the fitna of the women. Of the women. ما تركتوا بعدي فتنة أضروا على الرجال من النساء. They are big fitna. And if a man with a woman, they sit together in a place, Shaitan will be the third. Don't tell me I am Imam Shafi'i. You're not Imam Shafi'i. You're not any Imam. I'm telling you, women somehow they can attract men. For that's why be careful. When you look at your khatiba or that when you're gonna marry her, it's very important, as we said, according to the Sharia. I give you some dalil. وَقَدْ عَمِلَ بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ بَعْضُ الصَّحَابَةِ Some of the Sahaba, they practiced that, what Rasulullah SAW said. وَهُوَ مَسْلَمَ الْأَنصَارِ فَقَالَ سَهْلُ بْنِ أَبِي حَثْمَةِ رَأَيْتُ مُحَمَّدْ بْنِ مَسْلَمَةِ يُطَارِدْ بُثَيْنَ بِنْتِ الضَّحَّاكِ ببصره طردا شديدا. That Sahabi, he said, I saw Muhammad ibn Maslama, Sahabi, one of the Sahaba, was looking and staring to Buthayna, a lady, bint al-Dahhak, with his eyes. He's staring at her. فقلت أتفعل هذا وأنت صاحب رسول الله. Are you doing that while you are a companion of Rasulullah? Are you looking at the lady like that? فقال محمد بن مسلمة said, I heard رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا ألقي في قلب امرئ خطبة امرأة فلا بأس أن ينظر إليها. If you want to really marry a lady and if you are serious about this marriage, you can look at her like what I said. واختلف الفقهاء, the فقهاء of Islam, they have different in opinion. I will let you talk, but let me finish. Well, they have different opinions about looking at this woman. Number one, they said الوجه والكفين, like what I said, you can look at her face and you can look at her hand. وفيه تعطيل لفهم الصحابة ولا حجة فيه. يعني the one who said that, he said this is تعطيل to فهم to what the الصحابة understand, neglection of what the صحابة understood from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you just look at the face and the hand, which is they disagree, they want to look to something more. Yes, according to Hadith Muhammad ibn Maslama. وخطب عمر من علي أم كلثوم his daughter. عمر بن الخطاب he engaged or he get married from before the marriage. I was talking about أم كلثوم the granddaughter of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the daughter of علي بن أبي طالب, فاطمة. فعلي said she's still young, oh أمير المؤمنين. فأبعث بها إليك. علي رضي الله عنه said I will send my daughter أم كلثوم to you. فإن رضيت فهي امرأتك. فهي امرأتك. If you accept her, she's still young. But if you accept her, she's your wife. سيدنا علي told سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب ذات. فأرسل إليه أم كلثوم. And he sent أم كلثوم to أمير المؤمنين. فكشف عن ساقيها. And سيدنا عمر, since he saw her, he pulled up her clothes like this to see her legs. This is what سيدنا عمر did. فقالت لولا أنك أمير المؤمنين لسككت عنك عينيك. Because if you are أمير المؤمنين, otherwise I will get pull your eyes out. I gotta slap your face. She said that. That حديث رواه الحافظ في التلخيص وسند الحديث صحيح. وسند الحديث إيه؟ صحيح. طيب. نبي الله سليمان when he build up the صرح for بلقيس the queen of Sheba, and سبحان الله she was thinking the water, but the water was under the glass. For what she did. Some scholars of Tafsir, they said he make that not only for this purpose. He want to show her he has knowledge and power like her. And she did that purposely to see her legs because he had intention to marry from her. This is Sayyidina Sulaiman. Wallahu a'lam fi al-sawab. This is what we read. When she, Quran said that, فَكَشَفَ لَمَّا رَأَتُهُ حَسِبَتْهُ لُجَّةُ وَكَشَفَتْ عَنْ سَاقَيْهَا. When she saw the water, she was thinking it's a water. And that's why she start pulling up his tail of her clothes because the water, it was glass and the water under that. He saw her legs. قال ابن القيم في تهذيب السنن عن أحمد ثلاث روايات. إمام أحمد he said there are three narration of that. You can see her face and her hands. And you can, إمام أحمد said that ينظر إليها غالبا. Look at her body. طبعا of course she's not naked. يعني she's wearing clothes. You can look at her, all of her body, but not naked. She's covering herself. You can look at her neck, you can look at her legs. But ينظر إليها كلها عورة. And for me, المرأة كلها عورة. Women, all the women are عورة. عورة means we cannot look at her, all of her body. But you have intention to get married from her. But all of this is just stealing you whatever the fuqaha saying. That lady, she's gonna be my wife in the future. I wanna make sure she's the right one. I wanna make sure I have the communication with her. وانظر إليها نظر from where? When you look at the lady. Are you gonna look from here? You're gonna look with your eyes. She's gonna look at you with her eyes. That انظر إليها means that connection will come. And the connection comes with eyes. If you see some people, for example, they are debating. Did you see anybody debating with anybody? Looking at each others? No. They say, no, I told you. And they said, no, yeah, I told you. This is not right. And this is not right. Why? They are not looking at each other. But if they look to each other with their eyes, the communication will come and they will cool down. That's why Rasulullah when he used to shake somebody's hand, he never look at different way or something. He used to look at his eyes and he never take his hand first back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was waiting until that person's taking his hand away from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See, فالنظر في العين, you have to look at the eyes of somebody, even in America here. And women, some women, they get mad if some Muslim is, you say, I'm keeping my gaze. I'm haram, you know. What's wrong? Be serious and look at her. You're talking about business. Look at her. What's wrong with that? Did I tell you, have desire and look at her? No. Just for communication. You have to communicate with people around you. You know, that's why most of the fighting, because people, they doesn't want to look at each other. Even they doesn't want to listen to each other. That's why there is no communication. Just fight even between husband and wife. Did you see your wife when she fight with you? Did she look at your eyes? No. She said, can you miss with the magawistak? Don't give your daughter to somebody fasiq, rebellious, wrongdoer. Yeah, because really you're going to lose her if you're going to do that. Yeah. I think this is today. Inshallah, we continue tomorrow or next week. Inshallah.
So there's no specific definition of look here. How do I look? Now you said this guy say that. How can I look only to her face and her hands without seeing her body? I mean, she's wearing, of course, she's dressed.
Yes.
But I will see it all together. So why is it only face and hand?
This is what the scholar said.
The mask for the rest of her body?
If she's wearing her clothes, yeah, I agree. You can look at all of her body. Yeah. But some of the scholars, they said no. Without unknowingly from her, just you can spy behind her and where she's taking shower, and you can look at her. But some of the scholars, they said that Ibn Hazm Madrasa, the school of Ibn Hazm al-Zahri, they take the hadith as is and they put it as is. Of course, it is not acceptable.
Okay.
If she's wearing a cloth, her cloth. You can look at all of her body, why she's wearing her clothes. Exactly, this is what you can do. She's gonna be your wife. Maybe عرقة ولا حولة ولا she's limping ولا عندها عين ونص ولا حالتها مع لمبر. You know, you have to, and you can send your sister, you can send your mom, she can check up. Even she can smell her breath, because sometimes some women they have, yeah, there are too many things, you know.
Okay.
And لازم يعني من الآخر لازم تفحص البضاعة حلوة قبل ما تشتري. جزاك الله خير. And sister, also this is for, this applying for the brother and sister too. يعني I'm not trying to say the brother, they have the upper hand. But mostly the brothers, those who are asking to for the engagement. But also the sister, you have your own opinion too. Maybe you don't like him. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab one time, he was about, I'm gonna mention that later, he was about to get married from a lady, she rejected Umar. Yeah. Do you know why?
Yeah, he's for God.
Yeah, exactly. Umar, he's one of the people of al-Akhirah. He's not looking for dunya, and I want to enjoy my life. Umar is gonna make it hard for me. That's why she rejected him. You have your own choice, sister, to say this man gonna be my husband or not, but also you have to be reasonable, because most of the sisters, when they come to this point, they look at his beauty, the way he talks, and most of women like this. The one who's riding a white horse, you know, عنتر بن شداد فارس بني خيبان. ايوه جاي عشان يجوزها الخيبة دي. فهي لا, you have to evaluate him in the right way according to the deen and the sunnah, and you have to see that man he gonna be the father of your kids in the future. And your brother too, this lady, she gonna be the mother of your kids in the future. That's why one of the rights of our kids, inshallah later I'm gonna say that, to choose the good mother and to choose the good husband or father for your kids from now. When I was young, nobody told us this. But when we learn, we grow up. I wish if somebody was telling me that before. Alhamdulillah, I'm okay. I'm okay, but yeah, no, Allah, I'm okay, alhamdulillah. But it's better, I know, it's better. يا جماعة معلش بالغلط. الله انتوا خطرين انتوا الاثنين. Okay. هي the point here is, it's good to know. Because صراحة sometimes we miss a lot of things in our Islam when we were little because nobody teach us. We used to live in villages or wherever we used to live. Maybe subhanAllah we ignored, but more you read, more you learn. More you sit with the scholars, more you sit with elders, those who are older than you. You will learn too many things. When I was little, I said, I wish if somebody teach me this when I was little. Nobody was teaching me anything, you know. فالحمدلله رب العالمين, now we have the chance to listen to the mashayikh, to open this cellular phone or YouTube, whatever, to come to the masjid, to ask questions, you're gonna get the answer. Wallahi azim, ya jama'ah, before, we did not have any sheikh or anybody to teach us this. The sheikh is batikha, he used to say Allahu Akbar and he doesn't know how to read Surah Al-Fatiha and going home. That's it. Or our mashayikh batikha, big batikha. They don't know nothing. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Ameen, we are being blessed to know all of this information. Jazakum Allah khair. Do you have a question, Abu Ahmed? Allah يجزيكم الخير. ربنا اغفر لنا وتقبل منا وارحمنا واسترنا واجبرنا واهدنا يا ارحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.